So we mainly study biofilms in bacteria, and biofilms are these multicellular communities of bacteria. So if a bacteria is kind of swimming along and it finds a surface, it can attach to that surface. And once it attaches, it starts to divide, secretes this sort of extracellular substance called slime. And this can either be a sugar or a nucleic acid like DNA or something. And so what this slime does is it sort of encases the bacteria in this kind of protective shield. So the bacteria can avoid, getting eaten by predators or things of that nature in the environment. So we're studying sort of how biofilms form and bacterial pathogens and how they're involved in disease, doing a lot of basic research with that. Biofilms form inside the host, and there's two problems with that. One is that the bacterial immune system can't clear those bacteria because of this slimy armor layer. So you have the host cells can't eat the bacteria, and the antibodies that normally protect you from pathogens can't bind to those bacteria. So you have this kind of chronic wound that just lingers and lingers. And the second problem is that antibiotics that we use to treat bacteria, they're not as effective against biofilm growing bacteria because they're just more inherently resistant to antibiotics. So you have sort of these twofold problems where diseases associated with biofilms can't be cleared with normal antibiotics or the immune system. And the National Institutes of Health has estimated that 80% of all bacterial infections rely on biofilms to one extent or another. So it's a really big medical problem. And this molecule that we study seems to be the essential signal for forming biofilms in the vast majority of all bacteria. So there's a lot of, I think, really important questions in terms of how this is working and how this is involved in disease. So one thing that we're doing at sort of our applied side to the lab is we're trying to come up with ways to prevent the enzyme that makes this signal from working. Okay, so if you can shut down that enzyme, this enzyme takes these two GTPs together and makes the signal. If you can shut that down, you completely lower the levels of the signal and the bacteria don't form a biofilm. All right. So we've actually done a screen where we've screened 70,000 chemical compounds, and we have a number of lead compounds which seem to have lots of biofilm activity against a number of different bacterial pathogens. And we think that these could be really interesting therapeutics because, like I said, the vast majority of bacteria have the signaling system, and the enzymes all work the same way. Okay, so if you can inhibit the enzyme in one pathogen, it'll work in another. So this could be a broad spectrum kind of approach.